class number? It is class 8, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, you can see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
It is module 2, class 8, and we have to do multiplexers. Okay? Now, multiplexers are very, very important thing of digital electronics. Any big or small circuit will be using many multiplexers in its design. Okay? First, definition of multiplexer. A digital multiplexer is a combinational logic circuit which has 2 to the power n input and 1 output and n select line. I am repeating, digital multiplexer is a combinational logic circuit which has 2 to the power n input, 2 to the power n input, only 1 output, and it has n select line. Now this is something which is very different from your decoders, encoders, whatever you have seen till now. So the symbol of MUX I have shown because we have more number of input and only 1 output. The diagram is like this, a trapezium with a wider side at left and a smaller side at right. These are showing the select line. So you can see the relation between number of select line and number of input. So it has n select line and 2 to the power n input. So again, I am repeating the definition. Digital multiplexer is a combinational logic circuit which has n input lines and 1 output and n select line. Okay. Now I will show you 2:1 multiplexer. I will show you 2:1 multiplexer. And because 2:1 multiplexer is most simple one, you will understand the working of multiplexer with 2:1 MUX, and later you can use it for your higher level MUX. And if you understand the logic, then the designing part becomes very easy for you people. Okay. Now I am showing the block diagram of 2:1 MUX. But whenever we make in a big digital circuit, then we make this symbol. Seeing this symbol, anybody understand that it is a MUX. But showing you the working, I am making a box. And when I say 2:1 MUX, so how many inputs should be there?
4 inputs.
Right. And only 1 output will be there. And if 2 inputs are there, how many select lines will be there?
1, ma'am.
Correct. If n is 1, then 2 to the power 1 is 2. So you will have 1 select line. So I will call it as S only. Okay? I will call it as S only. Now, let me show you the truth table. How does it look like? Okay, now when I am talking about truth table, you should make along with me, okay, so that you understand and should not do any mistake. So how many inputs are there?
2, ma'am.
Inputs are 2. What do you will call for enable? Enable is an input or output?
That's an input.
Input, ma'am.
Enable is also input. D0, D1, your data line are also input, and select line is also input. All these 4 input together will decide your output. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Decide your output. Now, output is only 1. So you can see multiplexer 2:1 MUX has 4 input and 1 output. You all know the meaning of active low and active high by this time. So as you can see in the diagram, is there anything which is active low?
No, ma'am.
Everything is active high only. Now, enable, if I make it 0, means it is not allowing it to work. So, if it is not allowing it to work, what do you think D0, D1, S should be?
Negative.
It should be a don't care, is it not? Because if enable is zero, it is not bothered what is there at D naught, it is not bothered what is there at D1, it is not bothered what is there at S. And when nothing is there anywhere, then what will happen? It will not give any output and it will be at a ground. Output will be at a ground. Now when enable is there, and I select, see, select line means selection. So if S is zero, all of you understand this carefully. If S is zero, it establishes the connection between D0 to Y. And if S is 1, it establishes the connection between D1 to Y. So you have to understand here, when it is establishing, when S is equal to 0 and it is establishing connection between D0 and Y, whatever is there at D0 will be seen at Y. If D0 is 0, Y becomes 0. If D0 is 1, Y becomes 1. And the time when S is 0 and connection is established between D0 and Y, D1 is out of connection. There is no connection for this D1. So when there is no connection for D1, that time D1 becomes a don't care, because connection only is not there. The way when enable is 0, we don't make the multiplexer work. So all this becomes don't care. So the truth table of such four variable input will not be like the way you have been doing till now in your module 1 and module 2. It will be application based. It will be the working operation based of your multiplexer. So now let us start with the case when enable is 1 and my select line is 0. Now select line decides everything. Select line is one variable, means in digital electronics it can either be 0 or it can be 1. There is no third possibility here, right? If select line is 0, that means what? It is selecting D0 and your D1 becomes a don't care. Again, another case, if your select line is 0, D1 is don't care, there can be two possibilities. Number one possibility is D0 is a 0. If D0 is a 0, the same gets connected to output and output you get a 0. And when D1 is 1, same gets connected to output and output becomes 1. Because there is a connection established between D0 and Y, D0 and Y will follow each other, means Y will follow D0, D1 not bothered, and this happens only because S is 0. Select line is 0, selecting D0. Now you can tell me what should be in the third and in fourth and fifth row. You can only tell me what will be there in fourth and fifth row now.
And fourth row it will be don't for enable it will be 1, don't D not
no, enable 0 D,
enable will be 1 because it is enabling the multiplexer.
Yes, on D not will be don't care.
Yeah,
D1 will be 0. S will be 1.
Yes, now select line is establishing connection between D1 and Y, so Y will follow D1, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Again, if D1 is 1, Y will follow D1 only, and your D0 is a don't care. Is this truth table clear to all of you?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
All of you observe it carefully. Okay, now if I want to write an equation, of output, see, after a while you people will understand. But because it is your first multiplexer, I want you to write an equation. And what I want? I want to write you an equation of function y as function of D0, D1 and S. Can you see? I have purposely removed enable. I will show you later how to bring enable into picture. But if I am asking you, give me the equation for y in terms of D0, D1 and S, what you will do? How you will do? Without breaking your head, you can try with your KMAP. Okay? try with your KMAP. Because why three because it is three variable, I have only 8 cell KMAP, right? So it is D naught D1 S, right? D naught D1 S. And why in terms of D naught D1 S? So what will be your first one? It is D1 bar S bar, then it is D1 bar S, then D1 S, then D1 S bar. Here you have simply D0 bar and D. Okay, now tell me the output there and all, what will be there?
Ma'am, only for 2 and 4 there will be a 1.
For 2 and 4 there will be a
1.
1. Why only for 2 and 4? Why not for 6?
This will be don't care, ma'am.
Don't care means don't care can either be 0 or it can be 1, right?
Okay, sir. So everything above 4 will be don't cares.
Okay, so let us see. Let us see. Taking 1 into picture. So if I take this one, you see on the screen, if I take this one, if this is a 0, if D1 is a 0, then what it is? 1, 0, 0. And what is 1, 0, 0? 1, 0, 0 is a 4. So let me name here. Okay, so now you can see for a 1, it can be a 4. So 4 can be 1. And if it is a 1, so then it becomes 1, 1, 0. So it becomes a 6, right? It becomes a 6. What is the other possibility? Let us come here for this 1. For this 1, if it is a 0, it becomes 0, 1, 1. So a 3 will be 1, right? And if it is a 1, so 1, 1, 1 means 7 becomes a 1. Are you people understanding this?
Yes.
What did I do? I took care of where and all y is 1. So y was 1 for only 2 cases. So I took those 2 cases. Y is 1 here. But this is a don't care. So it can give me 2 possibilities now. So making this don't care as 0 and 1, 1 by 1, I got 1, 0, 0 and 1, 1, 0. 1, 0, 0 gave me 4 and 1, 1, 0 gave me 6. Same way I did for this last y1. And what happened for this? 0, 1, 1 gave me 3 and 1, 1, 1 gave me 7. Right? So now all rest will be 0. All rest will be 0. So now you have to show the grouping. So what does the grouping shows? Grouping shows I can have this one and I can have this one. Right? So what is it? What is it? Y is D1 S, right? Then what is the other one? D0
S dash.
Yes.
D0 S dash.
D0 S dash. Okay. Now you used your truth K map and you did this. But I want you to analyze this equation in a different way now. What you can see here, if S is a 1. If S is a 1, all of you see the equation now. If S is 1, S1 will make this S bar 0, right? I am taking a condition when S is 1. When S is 1, it becomes D1 into 1. And here it becomes D0 into 0. So D0 into 0 means this term is a 0. It does not contribute anything for a OR operation. One of the variable. But when D1, when S is 1, Y is equal to D1 only. Can you see what I'm trying to show here? Okay, let me show it explicitly, because if you understand this, all doubts will be clear. I am taking case 1. I am taking case 1 when S is equal to 1. When S is equal to 1, what your equation becomes? When S is 1, S becomes 1 and S bar becomes a 0. So what it becomes equal to? it becomes equal to d1, and anything odd with anything ended with d0 becomes a zero, and anything odd with a zero will be equal to your that variable only. So you can see that this equation is reducing to y equal to d1. Now when it reduces y equal to d1 means what? Whatever is there at d1 is connected to this. So we show, see that a connection is established like this. A connection is established like this. Now another case, in the same way, if you see the other case, if you see the other case, that is case 2, case 2, when s is equal to 0, same way what will happen? D1 into 0, and d0 is what? 0 bar. So d1 dot 0 ended with 0 remains 0, and d0 0 complement is 1, so it becomes a d0, and your y is equal to d0. So when y is equal, when s is equal to 0, the connection is established between d0 and 1. So what happens? Multiplexer is just establishing the connection between input and output based upon the code at select line. Based upon the code at select line. I hope you understood this. Now I have equation which you have got from your K-map as this. What if I want to bring enable into picture? What can be done? You all know that enable is something which is, if enable is 0, output becomes 0 and nothing happens. Your D not S does not matter anymore. But if enable is high, everything works. So what do you think? Output equation can change directly without going into K-map business. By this time, you should know to modify things like this. It becomes enable will simply come into picture like this. So if enable is 0, if enable is 0, this bracket means an AND gate here, okay? This bracket means an AND gate here. So whatever happens, enable is 0, whatever happens here, finally ANDed with a 0, output will remain 0. And if enable is 1, whatever happens with this part of the circuit will decide your Y. Is this clear? And if you want to use a 3-input AND gate, you can simply write E as part of each term. So E D1S and E D0S bar. Like this you can show. I hope you can make a basic gate circuit of this. Or you want me to show that? You can make a basic gate circuit of this. How many AND gates you will have? How many OR gate you will have? How many NOT gate you will have? Yes, tell me.
Two AND gate, ma'am. One OR gate.
And one NOT gate also, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So E you have, D0 you have, then you have a D1, and then you have a S, right? And your S has to be connected with a NOT gate, right? So one AND gate which is taking care of your D0 will have E0, E, D0 and S bar. So S bar, D0 and enable, a 3-input AND gate. Same way you will have another one in which it will be E, D1 but S. So S will come, D1 will come and your E will come, right? This is your circuit, and this is taking, this need to be put into one OR gate. OR gate means you get your Y with this, right? You get your Y with this. Is this clear? This is your 2:1 marks with the logic symbol, block diagram, truth table, K-map, equation and circuit. So if you understand this quickly, we should see what will happen. And I want you to understand the equation of 4:1 marks without making K-map. Without making K-map. Okay, so let us go to next, that is 4:1 marks. Now you should be smart enough to work for 4:1 marks without writing much. So let us see 4:1 marks. 4:1 marks will have how many input line, how many select line, how many total input will be there? Quickly.
Ma'am, we will have one enable as usual. We'll have four inputs and okay. Two select lines.
Okay. And the naming is important. Naming is important. So we will name it S0, S1 like this. Okay. So all of you know that when S0 is 0, 0, which will be selected? If S0 is 0, 0, D0 will be connected to Y. If S0 is 0, 1, D1 will be connected. If it is 1, 0, D2 will be connected. And if S1, S0 both are 1, 1, then D3 will be connected, right? So we have two select lines, four data lines, or we should say data input line. Can you tell me why I'm calling it as data input lines? Because it is actually transfer of data. Data means it can be 0, it can be 1. Okay, so 4 data input line, 2 select line, and of course you have 1 enable and 1 Y output line. Okay, now you can write the truth table, or you want me to write the truth table, or you can write it on your own.
Oh, give us 2 minutes, ma'am. We'll try, then we'll show it, ma'am.
Okay, you people try it. I am also writing. You do not see the screen. You try to write on your own. Actually, there is 2 ways of writing. I can simply write the concised truth table, or we can write a bigger truth table also. I will show you both. Of course, the first one, if enable is 0, nothing matters in the world. Everything is don't care and output is a 0, right? Now when enable comes into picture and when select line is 0, 0, Y is connected to what? Y is connected to D0, right? So if a 0 is here, 0 comes here. If a 1 is there at D0, a 1 comes there. Like this, you can complete your truth table. So all of you complete your truth table quickly. Right, there is one more smaller way of writing the truth table. I will show you that also. What does that say? Of course, you have one enable will be there as always. Okay, and it says that only depending upon S1 and S0. So it will show that if enable is E0, anyway S0 and S1 does not matter and Y becomes 0. Later, if enable is 1, I can simply say that when S0 and S1 are 0, 0, 0, Y0 gets connected to D0. Same way, if it is 0, 1, it gets connected to D1. And D2 and D3 when it is like this. This is another way of writing a concise truth table of MUX. Okay, concise truth table of MUX. Now, can you give me the equation of MUX without writing the KMAP? I explained you the equation for 2:1 MUX for this purpose only. Without writing the MUX. Yes, somebody tell me one of the term at least. Yeah.
It will be D0, S1 bar, S0 bar.
Very good. It will be S1 bar, S0 bar. When S1, S0 bar means it is talking about connection with D0.
D0.
Right. Same way, if it is S1 bar S0 means it is talking about the first one. If it is
D1.
If it is S1 bar S0 means it is talking about this row when it is connected to D1. Same way we can carry on. If it is S1 S0 bar, it becomes D2. And if it is S1 S0, it is D3. So you all know this. Now it is your choice to take a 4-input AND gate and connect enable to all the gates, or it is your choice to take 3-input AND gate, make it, and last one output will come with the ANDing of the result of the OR of this with the enable input. I hope you are understanding what I am saying. Either you will require 4-input AND, 4-input AND gate, if you are putting enable with all the terms, otherwise you require 3-input AND gate for these 4 terms, ORing all that and later ANDing. But as if you will see PLAs and other things also in your digital system design course, we will see that we keep generally all the AND at one place and all the OR at one place. It is not we do sandwiching of AND then OR then AND then OR. We don't do like this. So ANDing will be at one place, AND part will come, AND layer will come, and then OR layer comes. So you can do anyway, but if you go to the actual implementation of the circuit, AND should be done first. So it is preferable to take 4 input AND gate, 4 numbers, then put it into one OR gate. So you need to make circuit of this also. Okay, that I am leaving to you. I am writing here. You should remember, you have to make basic gate circuit for 4:1 MUX on your own. Okay, so this we can take it as homework. 4:1 MUX for basic gate circuit for 4:1 MUX. Same way you can get 8:1 MUX and 16:1 MUX, right? You understand the logic now? You can have 8:1 MUX and you can have 16:1 MUX. 8:1 MUX, how many select lines will be there?
3.
Correct. Because 2^3 is 8. So you will have 3 select lines. For 4:1 MUX, you will have 4 select lines. Now, next question. Next thing I want you people to know is how to make a 4:1 MUX using 2:1 MUX. Think over and tell me. And later I will also ask how to make 8:1 MUX using 2:1 MUX. Think and tell me now.